good morning and welcome to the program. Hard road. Have you been there before?
I've got a hard road to travel in a rough, rough way to go.
Hard road to travel.
Hard road to travel in a rough, rough way.
I repeat, have you been there?
But I can't turn
on life's a hard road before.
My mind's made up.
Mountains and valleys. Tests and trials.
We'll see me through.
Life's balance sheet can at times be very disturbing.
All alone.
You are all alone.
This lonesome road I roam.
On a lonesome road.
I've got no love.
No love anywhere.
Call my very own. Oh, the river gets deeper.
The river gets deeper.
Hills get steeper.
Hills get steeper.
And the pain,
gets deeper. Gets deeper.
Every day.
Oh, it's a hard road. Grace to grass, hero to villain. The ink is no longer on you, or on you, but negatively so. Yet you can't turn back. It's the only thing you know how to do. And this morning, we are looking at the life and the play. Right now, oh, Father, one time my goal adore, one time my goal thief, goal and linchpin, goal getter, super striker, the one called Radamel Falcao. Critics have gone to town, and words are bordering on the derogatory have been used to qualify him. Some say not good, to be offloaded, have lost form, can't deliver anymore, have seen his brightest days. It's a hard road for Falcao, I tell you.
Hey, I've got a hard road to travel in a rough, rough way.
Statisticians have also joined in giving figures of his one season in Manchester United. Isn't it amazing? You get into something, not knowing that they are watching and noting every move, everything you do, and will use it against you. And that's what they are doing right now, concerning the one-time goal scorer from Colombia. Their books tell that he has played 26 Premier League matches for Manchester United and has scored, embarrassingly so, just 4 goals. Has created 18 chances. Won only 19 headers, made just 13 dribbles in a whole season, and 9 tackles. They also tell that the fans are tired and say this guy must leave our club. Pundits have gone to town to say offload him. Don't waste our club's £43.5 million in buying outrightly. Well, that was what was done when he was told to come to the city called Manchester, to the club at Old Trafford. Monaco had said, as you take him on loan, you can also buy at the end of the season for £43.5 million. And the critics now say £15.5 million salary every year can no longer hold. He has lost his steam. He has lost his firepower. His boots are no longer good. It's a hard road. Destiny will release me. I must go. I will get better again. Jimmy Cliff sings this morning. And that's how the mother of this player has taken this. The mother of Falcao has spoken out there in Colombia. She was talking to the Colombian newspaper called El Espectador. And she has gone to the Celestial concerning this matter. The mother sees it as a spiritual sin and says, we hope for bigger and better sins. God hasn't abandoned us. And my son will become again what he has been, a goal scorer. It's not a normal situation, given what he has faced. But it happens in football, Mama says. And if God shows him a new pass, he will leave Manchester. If not, he will stay. And so Mama has gone celestial concerning the hard road that Falcao is traveling. Well, let's tell that before he faced the rough pass at Old Trafford, Falcao was respected everywhere because of his records. Falcao erased the record of 15 goals in a single club competition in Europe held by Jürgen Klinsmann when he scored 17 in 2011. He was also a super player for FC Porto when they won the Europa League title in the 2010-2011 season. And he was so good messing up goalkeepers and defenders that are in Atletico Madrid. They just started calling the club Atletico Falcao. You know what he also did? Hailing him. In 2012, FIFA named him number 5 in the whole world in terms of quality in naming players and ranking players. That same year, 2012, he was in FIFA's top 11 of players in the world. Portuguese Golden Ball winner 2010-2011, and I was a top scorer in the Europa League competition 2010-2011, 2011-2012, Europa League final man of the match for two seasons, 2011-2012. And this player who says he will continue to play football was the Super Cup, UEFA Super Cup man of the match in 2012. A man who never knew the bench in his days in Atletico Madrid and also FC Porto became the landlord of the bench at Old Trafford. A man who others watched do it for 90 minutes became the one watching others do it for 90 minutes at Old Trafford. Will he come out of this? Now all alone, this lonesome road, a lonesome road in Manchester. No love. The river gets deeper. The hills are getting steeper. And pain gets deeper. Will Falcao come out of this? The mother has gone spiritual. And mama said that we hope for bigger and better things. God has not abandoned us. And my son will become again what he has been, a goal scorer. It's not a normal situation we are in. Mama has gone spiritual, though. I dream of a home far beyond the sea. Mama is dreaming of where there is love. Peace and joy for me. Of where there will be peace and joy for her son. Where his eyes will see goals again. Where destiny will release him. And Mama says that is where this boy will end. 26 Premier League matches, 4 goals, 18 chances, 86% accuracy, but loaded with 19 headers, only 13 dribbles and 9 tackles. And any story concerning the player gets a space on television, on radio, in the papers. France Football magazine wrote that Monaco is already talking or looking at Mandzukic to join their club. And if Falcao returns, Falcao will be the understudy, not the number one striker. The man who is all alone, who is lonesome in Manchester, decided to see someone to talk with only a few days ago. And the person, not his coach, not team members, but his baba, Falcao. Has seen his barber, talked with the barber, and now has a new haircut. And some are saying, new look, new you. And that is preparing his heart, his mind, to come out of the hard road. It's also been reported in the UK that Manchester United is getting set to offer Falcao to Chelsea so that he will become an addition to the backup that Chelsea has for Diego Costa. Mourinho has not said that he will take. One more thing. They are also saying that he sent a tweet to fans of Manchester United where he told them, the experience here is unforgettable and I want to thank you all for everything. Paul Scholes, analyzing it, says that is his own way of saying bye-bye to the Old Trafford side and that he thinks Falcao will not remain in Manchester United. The fans have said that this man should be released. And the coach of Man U has spoken about what he'll be doing during the summer transfer. Manchester United, Louis van Gaal says, will be very busy in the summer talking about transfers. But as the player remains on the hard road, the coach has not said that we are going to offload him and indeed give support to the player. I have said more or less to him that he can show his class again. I have a lot of confidence in him, the Dutch said concerning Rodemar Falcao. I have said more or less to him that he can show his class again. I have a lot of confidence in him, end of quote. And as he continues to be on the lonesome road, support has also come from his former coach at Monaco, Claudio Ranieri, one-time coach of Chelsea, has talked. Ranieri says he's a fantastic player, fantastic in the box. And what has happened to him this one season in Manchester is strange, very strange. I believe that he will come out of it. This hard road that will go away. And that is coming from the current coach of AS Monaco, Leonardo Yadim, who has said that this player will have brighter days again. The sun will rise again for this player.
One more thing, I dream of a home far beyond the sea, where there is love and peace and joy for me.
Peace and joy for my son.
Oh, in my eyes I see.
With my eyes I'll see him shine again. Destiny will release him.
I must go.
My man went spiritual.
Hey, I've got a hard road.
And so everyone says it's a hard road. But three strategists have talked that this boy will bounce back. Indeed, I remember that in the season 2006-2007, for 6 months, injuries blighted his goal scoring form. And for 6 months, Falcao did not play football. But he came out of that and enjoyed a great ink and the high praise of writers everywhere and commentators. Because after the 2006-2007 injury, that he started hitting, breaking and making records. Became the superstar at FC Porto, a bigger star at Atletico Madrid, and a super at AS Monaco. Colombia's biggest name right now in football.
Let me tell you, I'm all alone.
And they say he's just 29. Was 29 on the 10th of February.
No love.
And also argue that he still has many years to score and score well in front of him. And so, as the pain gets deeper, and no one knows now whether the player will leave Man U or whether Man U will offload him or offer him to Chelsea. Indeed, and in fact, as has been published by those who speculate, or whether to now return him to Monaco and say, sorry, we are not buying bad product. The question for you is a simple one this morning. Mama says, the face of our family, our belief in God, will see our sons through. The three coaches who have worked with him say they dream of that day when he will bounce back, and they know he will bounce back.
Well, there is love.
There will be love again for him.
Peace and joy for me.
Peace and joy for him again, says Louis van Gaal. The troubles and pain will go, say Ranieri and Yadim. And so the question this morning, maybe in Manchester or even at Chelsea, it could be AS Monaco. Do you see this man, Radamel Falcao, becoming the top goal scorer that he was a few seasons ago again? Do you see this man hitting at the dizzying heights he took goal scoring to again? A very simple one this morning. Larry Zamo, just my name, your turn now, bye-bye.
I dream of a home far beyond the sea, where there is love and peace and joy for me. Oh, in my eyes I see troubles and danger for me, but destiny, where it leads me, I must go. Hey, I've got a hard road to travel and a rough way to go. Said it's a hard road.